Hello everybody, it's me Juan David, JD Films. The video that you are going to see is like a inspiration, is like a motivation. Because you people that you like films, and also you are a filmmaker and you like to record something and you like to love making movies, this video is for you guys and for me, of course, because I like films, I like to record, I like to do anything with the camera. And also the people that are getting started in this professional career, this is a motivation for you guys, because the person that you are going to see is my favorite director, and you know who is the one and only Steven Spielberg, that made a lot of films. But this is like my favorite film, Jurassic Park. And this is the only film that I got love to make films. This is like my starry dream. And that day, my dream come true. After a lot of years seeing his movies. So enjoy the video, subscribe to my channel, put a like in this video, follow me on Instagram, JDFilms_NY. See you
for 20 p.m. April 26, 2018.
I stopped here to tell you that I thought I was late, because the event to see Steven Spielberg, it was at 6:30 p.m.
What time we are going there?
Is there another way we can go, like, little early?
Right now,
like,
we are traffic. This is Google. This way is better than other way.
Okay. Yeah, they're It's a lot of traffic today.
Yeah, today is Thursday. is the traffic time.
Mm-hmm.
Cell phone goes in here, keys, all the metal objects out of your pockets. You can put your camera down here, it's gonna stay on this side.
Yeah?
No, you can keep your wallet, metal objects. Yeah, your keys, all right, no problem. Camera comes off and I'll push it on.
In the seat that I was selected and that I paid, I could not see the stage since I had a big camera. What I did next was something spectacular and epic.
Good. Huh? A camera? No, I cannot use it.
No, no.
A new seat.
Okie dokie.
The good thing is that you need to do something very crazy in a crazy day. They chase me in the seat and I am close, very close to the scenario. That day, I am going to cry because I need to do this, man. I cannot see the scenario with this big camera. The only thing I need to do is I need to go fast.
No.
I like this.
I'm not saying
I am dealing with this cell phone because I cannot use my camera, the big camera. Man.
How is it? How's the experience so far? Incredible, right? Those crazy things I do that day in that theater. And also the movie Schindler's List, it was crazy. because like the movies, the presentation start like 6:30 or 6:30 something, and almost the movie finished like 9:30. 3 hours seeing the movie, and I think they changed everything because the movie went too longer. And also, wow, in the end, people applaud the actors and also the Steven Spielberg, and people was very happy to see him. The good thing is the questions. I don't record the questions because my cell phone was very full. I can't record anything, and I cannot use this camera because the tele doesn't allow me. You see me before when the video started, so I couldn't do anything. But you see in YouTube.
I think we were all the subject matter and the impact of film on all of us, the cast, the filmmakers, the crew, everybody that made an appearance in this story. Took sort of the celebration out of that. It was wonderful to win. But at the same time, I just remember how moved I was when Bronco Lustig, our co-producer, showed the world that he was in Auschwitz too. And he had the numbers on his arm. And I just remember, I don't remember a lot about that night, but I really remember pleading with the audience or with the people watching. I pleaded with the teachers to please teach this in their schools. And I said, that's the most urgent thing you can do. You need to teach this story because you're right. Before Schindler's List, not very many young people knew about the Shoah. And they knew about it for a couple of years after this because we started the Shoah Foundation.
I see one camera and I was thinking that the Tribeca Film Festival was going to record that band because the band is a Schindler's anniversary. So I'm surprised that they don't record nothing. Even I stopped the video in the beginning because I want to record the questions. My questions that I have written. This is the question. Hello, Steven Spielberg. My name is Juan David. I am your biggest fan and inspiration to make films. And this is the question. How do you get the inspiration as a director for doing Jurassic Park, Schindler's List, and your last movie, The Ready Player One? A surprise for you guys. I was going to do something crazy in the theater with a lot of people. Also, I don't know, I want you with your name, you can sign your name in the movie. Thank you so much. I couldn't ask him questions because the lady that was asking questions, she was, I think, very old, and she's not getting the questions right. She was taking some many times asking questions about the crew of the Schindler's List. So I couldn't ask anything. The band finished, so I went very fast outside because I want him sign the movie. right? I want him sign the movie because I want to see his name in the movie he made. Man, I couldn't see him because was a lot of people. With flyers, with E.T., and the different movies, Jaws, and me with the teacher of T-shirt of Jurassic Park, and the movie, I couldn't see him. I don't know. After the presentation, I don't know. He went to the another direction and he left. The only thing I saw that day was the actors, but even the actors, they just left. That day was very cold and people was waiting. The good thing is that I made my dream come true. And makes me happy because Steven Spielberg is my inspiration, is my motivation, and after that day, I just love films. I just love making videos, and I'm making YouTube videos for you guys. And also, I was thinking, really, I was thinking, after 10 years to finish this channel, to finish the videos I've done, I was thinking that this is going to be the last video for my YouTube channel. But I think if I love films and I love editing and I love everything I do, I want to be staying in my YouTube channel, because this channel I created 10 years ago, and I'm going to be working, getting some views and getting more subscribers, and I am going to be done. Maybe this year I'm going to get soon 1,000 subscribers. Man, almost, it's almost there. Almost there. Almost there. That's crazy. That's crazy. That's very crazy. Man, this is my work. This is like what I done. And even with the kids playing, this is my player, my little game. And Steven Spielberg, thank you so much for making my dreams come true. Thank you for your videos, for your movies. And thank you for making my childhood happy with Jurassic Park. And your last movie, Ready Player One, was crazy movie. And I hope next year you can get your third Oscar. You are the most perfection director in the whole time. And maybe you are going to see this video. Even I have no words right now. But thank you so much. Thank you so much. You are my inspiration. And I'm starting to make my next movie soon. And I want to be a filmmaker. That's it. I can't. Guys, follow your dreams. Follow your inspiration, and please subscribe to my channel. put a like on this video. You're going to see for you guys and for me, of course, a little piece of Steven Spielberg inspiration speech.
When you have a dream, and the dream isn't something you dream and then it happens, the dream is something you never knew was going to come into your life. Dreams always come from behind you, not right between your eyes. It sneaks up on you. But when you have a dream, it doesn't often come at you screaming in your face, this is who you are, this is what you must be for the rest of your life. Sometimes a dream almost whispers. And I've always said to my kids, the hardest thing to listen to, your instincts, your human personal intuition, always whispers, it never shouts. Very hard to hear. So you have to, every day of your lives, be ready to hear what whispers in your ear. It very rarely shouts. And if you can listen to the whisper, and if it's, it tickles your heart, and it's something you think you want to do for the rest of your life, then that is going to be what you do for the rest of your life, and we will benefit from everything you do.